Let somebody shout hallelujah. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting Father, King of kings and the Lord of lords, the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the author and the finisher, the one that can connect and disconnect, the one that can promote and then demote, the one that can lift up and bring down. The Almighty God, he said that nobody can query. We want to bless you again for another moment of truth in your presence. Accept our times in the mighty name of Jesus. Unto you we've come once again to be blessed in your word. I pray today for myself and for everyone that listens to us across the nations of the world, that this word will bless us greatly today, and our lives will never remain the same again in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Almighty Father. In Jesus' wonderful name, we pray. Amen and amen. Once again, I want to welcome you into another edition of the Moment of Truth in the name of God the Father, and God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. I pray today that the Almighty God will bless us together in the mighty name of Jesus. Can I hear you say a louder amen? The theme of our message today is connecting the unconnected. Connecting the unconnected. Our text is taken from Genesis chapter 40, verse 14. Genesis chapter 40, verse 14. I read, Bethel come in when it shall be well with thee, and show kindness, I pray thee, unto me, and make mention of me unto Pharaoh, and make mention of me unto Pharaoh, and bring me out of this place, and bring me out of this place. This was Joseph crying, begging, appealing to the chief butler, the man that Joseph interpreted the dream for. He told him, in 3 days' time, the king will restore you to your original position as the chief butler. But when you get back to the palace, make mention of me to the king so that the king can come and rescue me out of this prison, because I was prison without committing any offense. The wife of my master, Potiphar, lied against me because I refused to sleep with her. So she lied against me, and then my master came. He did not even listen to me. He sentenced me into this prison yard without fair hearing, without trial. So now that God has used me for you to interpret the dream for you, and now the interpretation has come to pass, and the king has called for you for your restoration. So please, as you go back to the palace, as you get to the palace, please try to connect me to the king. Try to connect me to the king. And then the chief butler promised him, don't worry, you've helped me, I'm going to help you. When I get to the palace, I will connect you to the king by mentioning your name. But this man, the chief butler, got to the palace, and for 2 complete years, he forgot Joseph, the man that helped him to interpret his dream. He forgot him completely for a whole 2 years. So he failed to connect Joseph to the king. Don't forget, the theme of our message is connecting the unconnected. And going by the message, Joseph became the unconnected. He became the unconnected because the person that was positioned to connect him forgot him. Are you listening to me today? Maybe you are also among the unconnected. There are people that you know you very well, that ought to mention you to some people, that ought to connect you to some people who can help you, but they either forget to connect you or they refuse to connect you, or the enemy made them not to connect you. You are among the unconnected. But then I have good news for you today. My God is here to connect you, the unconnected, in the mighty name of Jesus. Why can't you say by faith, God will connect me? God will connect me. God will connect me. Can I hear you say it again 3 times loud and clear? Or can God himself hear you say it again 3 times? That God will connect me. God will connect me. God will connect me. And so shall it be in the mighty name of Jesus. Say a louder amen. But then after 2 years, something happened. In Genesis chapter 41, 9 to 14. Genesis chapter 41, 9 to 14. After King Pharaoh had 2 dreams that none of his magicians could interpret. None of them could interpret. But then the chief butler said, oh, I remember my fault now. 2 years ago, I was in a prison. A man met us there, and he interpreted my dream for me, and it came to pass. And he pleaded when I was going that I should connect him, but I forgot. He said, I remember my fault now. Let us read it together. Genesis chapter 41. We only read in verse 9. Then spake the chief butler unto Pharaoh, saying, I do remember my fault this day. I do remember my fault this day, because I forgot the man that helped me. I did not remember to connect him. I pray for somebody today. Everyone that God has positioned to connect you and that has forgotten you, today, my God will keep your matter in their mind, and they will not have peace of mind again until they connect you. In the mighty name of Jesus, God will open their eyes to locate you so that they can connect you. God will open their heart to remember you, and then they will connect you in the mighty name of Jesus. That was how Joseph was taken out of the prison yard and was brought to the throne. He was connected. That day, the unconnected was connected. The unconnected was connected. I have good news for you today. God is about to connect you, the unconnected, to greatness in the mighty name of Jesus. If you are the person, you have to say a louder amen. The sheep butler failed to connect Joseph to Pharaoh, but then God himself did the connection. There are some people also today, you have done good to many people. Listen, you are hearing me now, but you have done good to many people in the past, and now those people, they are now in a better place to help you, but they just forget you. They are in a better place to connect you to the topmost people, but they just decided not to connect you. They refuse not to connect you. Or maybe they are forgotten the good thing you did for them. Don't worry. My God is about to remember you. My God is about to connect you. That God that connected be unconnected, Joseph, he will also connect you in the mighty name of Jesus. To some people, it may be your father or your mother, I mean your parents, that helped some people in the past. And now, those people that your parents helped, those people that your parents helped now, they are now in better positions to compensate, to reward your parents by rewarding you, the children. But now, they don't even remember you. They don't even remember that good thing that your parents did for them. They have forgotten you. Maybe it is your parents that sponsored them to greatness. Maybe it is your parents that sponsored their education. Maybe it is your parents that even sent them to overseas country to go and study. Now they are there. They are now worthy. They are very important there. Instead of them to remember what your parents, what your parents did for them, they just decided not to remember again, and then they decided not even to compensate you, the children. Don't worry, my God is here today to connect you to greatness. He is here today to remember you and to remember the kind gesture of your parents, to remember the kind gesture of your father, of your mother. To some people that have forgotten you now, they may forget you, they may forget the good work of your parents over them, but God can never forget you. That is the good news today, that God can never forget you. So be ready for divine connection. My God will connect you, the unconnected, in the mighty name of Jesus. Say a better amen. Now, I told you for 2 years, Joseph was not connected. He was not connected. Now, we want to see the process of divine connection of Joseph. The process of divine connection of Joseph. Number one, God made Pharaoh to have a dream that no man, none of his magicians could interpret. For God to connect Joseph the unconnected, God made Pharaoh to have a dream. He had a dream that none of his magicians could interpret. Now, when God will decide to connect you, he can create a very difficult situation somewhere, a situation that no other person will be able to solve except you. I fear God. When God decides to favor somebody, he can use anything, he can use any means. So don't worry, your divine connection is around the corner. Number two, God caused the sheep butler to now remember Joseph by connecting to Pharaoh. Now, God now calls the sheep butler after 2 years to remember Joseph. Let me tell you, as you listen to this message, God will initiate your divine connection. God will initiate how you are going to be connected to somebody, to some people that will now help you in life. Can I hear you say amen to that loud and clear? So it was God that now put it in the heart of the sheep butler to remember Joseph. Let the sheep butler alone, he will never remember Joseph. But thank God that God created a situation in the palace that made the sheep butler to remember Joseph. Eventually, it was God all the way. It was God that created a situation that will make Joseph to be connected. It was that God that now put the remembrance of Joseph in the heart of the man that forgot Joseph for the past 2 years. I pray today, my God, we create a situation somewhere, somewhere, for you to be remembered for divine connection in the mighty name of Jesus. And everyone that failed to connect you in the time past, one by one, God will be planting your love in their heart. One by one, they will all remember you and they will connect you to greatness. They will arise for your help and they will help you in the mighty name of Jesus. So shall it be in the mighty name of Jesus. What are we seeing? It is God and God alone. It is God that can connect you the unconnected. So be ready for divine connection today that will settle you for life in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, through that connection, Joseph secured 7 special miracles. This is the core of the message. This is the core of the message. So we are talking about connecting the unconnected. Now, God connected Joseph to the throne. And as a result of that connection, God handed over to Joseph 7 special miracles. I pray for you today, as you listen to this message, my God will also give you that 7 special miracles in the mighty name of Jesus. Miracle number 1, we are talking about the miracles that will happen to somebody that God connect himself. I pray that God will connect you and this miracle will happen in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Miracle number 1 is the miracle of divine commendation. Miracle of divine commendation. In Genesis chapter 41 verse 39, Genesis 41, 39, and Pharaoh said unto Joseph, for as much as God has shielded thee, all these, there is none so discreet and wise as thou art. Can we see? Pharaoh commended Joseph. He told Joseph, you are the wisest. You are the very best. In all the land of Egypt, in all the nation of Egypt, there is no one that is as wise as you. You are the best. What a commendation. I pray for somebody today. God himself will commend you. And God will arrange special occasion of commendation to you in the mighty name of Jesus. You know, there are some people, even when they do things, when they do good things to people, instead of commending them, they will condemn them. You have done your best, you have done good to many people, but instead of you receiving commendation, it is condemnation. They hate you, they condemn you for every good thing that you did. But now, God is changing your condemnation to commendation. If you are the person, you better say, I receive it, and so shall it be for you in the mighty name of Jesus. So miracle number 1 is the miracle of divine commendation. Your commendation is around the corner. God will arrange special occasion of commendation for you. People will gather to commend you and to celebrate you in the mighty name of Jesus. You better say a louder amen. Miracle number 2, when God connects the unconnected Joseph, then he got miracle number 2. And what is that miracle? Miracle of divine authority. Divine authority. Genesis chapter 41, verse 40. Genesis 41, verse 40. Thou shalt be over my house. That was Pharaoh talking to Joseph. He said, thou shalt be over my house, and according unto thy word shall all my people be ruled. Can we hear that? Only in the throne will I be greater than thou. Pharaoh told a slave, a prisoner, a stranger, Joseph, a small boy, he told him, thou shalt be over my house, that is, you are going to be in charge in the palace. And according to your word, shall my people be ruled. He handed over authority to rule to Joseph. That is miracle of divine authority. He said, according to your word, my people shall be ruled. That is, whatever you say will surely come to pass. Whatever you decree in the land of Egypt, nobody will change it. Your word will become a law, a decree in the land. What an authority. Now, I want to decree into your life today, as you are hearing me, that my God will also give you such a divine authority in the mighty name of Jesus. So that after this message, whatever you decree will surely come to pass. When you decree a thing, it will surely come to pass. When you say, good things come to me, good things will come to you. When you say, evil things leave me, that evil thing will leave you. I want us to accept it now by faith that God has given you, he has given me a new authority to decree and for it to come to pass. Now, I want to encourage us, all of us now, to gently decree that in the name of Jesus, coronavirus, leave our world. In the name of Jesus, let us decree and pronounce coronavirus dead in every nation of the world. Now, decree an end to the spread of coronavirus in our world. Decree an end to this pandemic in our world. Decree an end to this plague called coronavirus in our world. Decree an end to this noisy pestilence in our world. The noisy pestilence that is coronavirus in our world. Why can't you use that man? Why can't you use that mouth now to decree better things into your life? Decree better things into your life. Decree progress into your life. Decree prosperity into your life. Decree success into your life. Decree breakthrough into your life. Decree abundance into your life. Decree riches into your life. Decree wealth into your life. Decree victory into your life. Decree greatness into your life. And so shall it be in the name of Jesus. Even decree holiness into your life. Say that from today, the grace to be holy within and without, I receive. Decree all the good things into your life in the mighty name of Jesus. And so shall it be in the mighty name of Jesus. Why can't you decree once again that I shall be the head and not the tail? In the mighty name of Jesus, I shall be above always and not beneath. In the mighty name of Jesus, just start to decree good things to yourself and it shall come to pass in the name of Jesus. Because God has given you the authority to decree in the mighty name of Jesus. And you have everything you decree for yourself and for others, for the nations of the world, in the mighty name of Jesus. Say better, amen. Now, miracle number three, that Joseph the unconnected God when he was connected. Miracle number three is the miracle of divine lifting. Miracle of divine lifting. A slave boy now became the leader over the nation of Egypt. What a lifting. It is not ordinary. It is not natural. It is divine. It is divine. And it could only be God. It's your turn to be lifted beyond every imagination, beyond every expectation in the mighty name of Jesus. In Genesis chapter 41, verse 41, we can see there. Genesis 41, 41. I read, and Pharaoh said unto Joseph, he says, see, I have set thee over all the land of Egypt. See, I have set thee over all the land of Egypt. God is telling you today, see, I've set you over all the land of your country. You mention your country in the mighty name of Jesus. God is telling somebody today, I've set you over all the nations of the world. You shall be the head and not the tail. If you are the person, you better say a louder amen. So when Joseph the unconnected was connected, the day was connected, he received miracle of divine lifting. Number four, he also received the miracle of divine enthronement. He received the miracle of divine enthronement. It takes a miracle for a slave to be enthroned as a prime minister in the place of his slavery, in the land of his slavery, in the place of his activity. It takes a miracle. It can be only God. It can be only God. He was enthroned divinely. To Joseph, it was unmerited throne. He lacked the credentials for that throne. He was not a citizen of Egypt. But then God enthroned him. He gave him the unmerited throne. I want to decree into your life today that God that did that unforget for Joseph, he will do it for you. And my God will also give you unmerited throne. It can be spiritual throne. It can be financial throne. It can be marital throne. Like that of Esther. They say you are not qualified to occupy this position because of your tribe. The position is not for your tribe. God will give you that position in the mighty name of Jesus. They say you lack the educational or the academic or the professional credentials for that position, but my God will connect you to that position. To then, you don't merit it, but my God is a specialist in giving people the unmerited throne. He did this for Esther, he will do it for you. He did it for Joseph, he will do it for you. In the mighty name of Jesus, you better say a louder amen. Now, let us see the details of that unmerited throne in Genesis chapter 41, 42 to 43. Genesis 41, 42 to 43. And Pharaoh took off his ring from his hand and put it upon Joseph's hand. Can we see? And array him investor of fine linen, that is royal garment, and put a gold shield about his neck, and he made him to ride in the second chariot which he had, the royal chariot, and they cried before him, bowed the knee, and he made him ruler over all the land of Egypt. Joseph was enthroned. He was given the throne of Pharaoh. In the land of Egypt, he was enthroned. Unmerited throne was given to him. It is your turn to be enthroned in the mighty name of Jesus. I want to decree into your life, there is a financial throne waiting for you to occupy. To the singles, there are marital thrones waiting for you to occupy. To a politician, there is a political throne waiting for you to occupy. There is a throne waiting for you, a throne of success to occupy. You'll be there in the mighty name of Jesus. Say better amen. Miracle number five, miracle of a new name. The day God connected Joseph the unconnected, he was given a new name in Genesis chapter 41 verse 45. Genesis 41 verse 45. I read, and Pharaoh called Joseph's name Saphatanea, and he gave him to wife Asenath, the daughter of Potipharah, priest of On. And Joseph went out over all the land of Egypt. And you see, Joseph was given a new name. What is your name? Listen to me. What is your name? Because today, my God is going to give you a new name. Let me tell you, before you answer that question, your real name is not the one given to you by your parents or the one you got during the time of your baptism. No, your real name is the name given to you by situations around you. Maybe your name is Mary, but if you are barren, people will not call you by your real name. They will call you by the name of your problem. They will say, look at that lady. She's barren. Maybe you are poor. They won't call you Mr. John, but they will say, look at that man coming, a beggar, a poor man. They call you by the name of your problem. They call you by the name of your sickness. Let me tell you, your real name is the one given to you by situations around you. But today, the world is giving you bad name. They name you after your problem. But today, you are going to get a new name. A name that will change your situation for the better. A name that will tally with your new situation. Can I hear you say amen in the mighty name of Jesus? They used to call you a failure. Your new name is going to become a success in the mighty name of Jesus. They used to call you a barren woman. Your new name will soon become the mother of twins. When they see you, they don't call you barren woman again, but they call you the mother of twins. Your old name, they call you a debtor. But when they see you, they will call you a worthy person, a creditor in the mighty name of Jesus. So God is about to change your name. If you agree with me, you better say a louder amen. How do I know? Because God is about to connect you in the mighty name of Jesus. Miracle number 6 that Joseph got when he was connected. He got the miracle of a new wife. The miracle of a new one, a new wife. Genesis 41, 45. Genesis 41, 45. And Pharaoh called Joseph's name Saphatnia, and he gave him to wife Asenath, the daughter of Potiphar, prince of On. Can we see? He was given not only a new name, he was given a wife. A wife. He never negotiated for a new wife. He was not even planning for a new wife, but then he was given a new wife. A new wife. Now listen to me. If you are married, I'm not saying that God will give you a new wife. No. If you are married and you are planning for a new wife, that new wife will take you to her. That is it. But let me tell you, if you are not married and you are preparing for a new wife or new husband, today, my God will connect you to that new wife and the new husband in his own way, better way. And very, very soon, you will be celebrated maritally in the mighty name of Jesus. You better say amen to that. But then there is something I want us to know in the book of Proverbs chapter 18, verse 22. Proverbs 18, verse 22. The Bible says, whoso findeth a wife, findeth a good thing. Underline a good thing. And obtaineth favor. Underline favor of the Lord. Now, a new wife can mean a good thing. A good thing. So when God connects you, good things will follow. Every good thing that your heart desire, you will get. You are already married. You don't need another husband or another wife. But God will grant you new things and good things that your heart desire. He say favor. The Lord will also grant you favor in all your way, in all your life, in the mighty name of Jesus. All this will happen to you because very, very soon, my God will connect you in the mighty name of Jesus. You are connected, but be ready for divine connection in the mighty name of Jesus. And last one, number seven, the miracle of actualization of visions and dream. Don't forget, David, at the age of 17, he had two dreams. He saw himself becoming a leader. But then, you know what? His brethren, the children of the same father with him, they say, no way. They say, no way. He will never become our leader. He will never become a ruler. Now, let us see it, their resolution. When they decided to do something, let's look at it. The resolution of his brethren. As regard the dream, the vision of Joseph. in Genesis chapter 37, 19 to 20. Genesis 37, 19 to 20. Now listen to it. And they said one to another. Those are the brethren of Joseph. Behold, this dreamer cometh. Come now, therefore, let us slay him. Let us kill him and cast him into some pit. And we will say, some evil beast had devoured him. And we shall see what became of his dream. In some blood, brethren, they say, let us kill him so that his dream and his vision will not come to pass. No wonder Jesus said, a man's foe shall be they of his own household. And then Prophet Micah also re-echoed it. Say, a man's enemy shall be those of his own household. His own blood brethren, brothers of the same father, they say, we are going to kill him so that his destiny will not come to pass, so that his dream and his vision will never see the light of the day. But then, God was a step ahead of them. And through divine arrangement, you know, he was eventually taken out of the pit. He was sold to slavery, from slavery to prison, from prison he was connected to the throne. I pray for you today, whichever level the enemy has already pushed you to, from there, my God will take you out and connect you to the very top, where your dream and your vision will come to pass in the mighty name of Jesus. Say a louder amen. Now, let us see the details of the actualization of his vision and his dream. Genesis chapter 41, verse 46. Genesis 41, verse 46. And Joseph was 30 years old when he stood before Pharaoh, king of Egypt. And Joseph went out from the presence of Pharaoh and went throughout all the land of Egypt. At the age of 30, the dream, the vision of Joseph to become a leader, a ruler, came to pass. After 13 years, he had the dream, he had the vision at the age of 70. And for 13 years, the enemy tried to destroy the fulfillment of that dream. But God said, no, I'm going to connect you. And God connected him to the point of fulfillment and actualization of his dream. May I pray for somebody today? God that connected Joseph to the actualization and the fulfillment of his dream and his vision will also connect you. And your dream, your vision in life will be actualized in the mighty name of Jesus. Only one thing you need to do in case you are still a sinner, in case you still live in sin, let me tell you, without sin, God can never connect you. Because God connected Joseph because Joseph lived holy life. When he was offered free sin, he said, no way, how can I do this one and sin against God? It's a food for thought. Brethren, you want God to connect you, you have to do away with sin. Maybe you are still a sinner, or you were born again before, but now you are a bastarder. Why can't you bow down your head and pray, Lord, I am a sinner, forgive me my sin, forgive my sin. I am a sinner, I don't have any excuse. God, forgive me my sin in the mighty name of Jesus. Pray to God and he will forgive you in the mighty name of Jesus. And then be ready for divine connection in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Right now, we want to pray seven prayers quickly. And I want you to pray the prayers loud and clear. As you pray this prayer, my God will start to connect us with the unconnected to greatness in the mighty name of Jesus. Prayer number one, shout the name of Jesus and say, oh God, arise and connect me to a path of destiny in the name of Jesus. Oh God, arise and connect me to a path of destiny in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, arise and connect me to a path of destiny in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. Prayer number two, shout the name of Jesus and say, Almighty Father, in your divine mercy, connect me to miracles that surpasses my expectation. Almighty Father, in your mercy, connect me to miracles. Connect me to miracles that surpasses my expectations. You know, Joseph never expected 7 miracles at a go, but then God gave him 7 miracles when he connected him to the throne. So now pray, Almighty Father, in your divine mercy, connect me to miracles that surpasses my expectation in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Prayer number three, shout the name of Jesus and say, oh God, connect me to greatness that will downfall my enemies. Greatness that will just downfall my enemies, that will silence them in the mighty name of Jesus, that will make them to open their mouth and they will be able to close it. Oh God, connect me to greatness that will downfall my enemies in the mighty name of Jesus. Give me miracles. Connect me to greatness that will downfold my enemies in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, connect me to greatness that will downfold my enemies in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. Prayer number four. Shout to the name of Jesus and pray. Oh God, arise and connect me to unmerited thrones. Oh God, arise and connect me to unmerited thrones. You connected Joseph to unmerited throne. Connect me also to unmerited throne in the mighty name of Jesus. You connected David to unmerited throne. Connect me to unmerited throne in the mighty name of Jesus. You connected Esther to unmerited throne. Connect me also to unmerited throne in the mighty name of Jesus. You even connected Mordecai to unmerited throne. Let me be another candidate for connection to unmerited throne in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. Number five, shout in the name of Jesus and say, Almighty Father, connect me to a new name that will silence my enemies forever. Almighty Father, connect me to a new name that will silence my enemies forever. They used to call me Mr. Failure. For now on, do something great. Connect me so that my name will change to Mr. Success in the mighty name of Jesus. Almighty Father, connect me to a new name that will silence my enemies forever in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. Prayer number six, shout the name of Jesus and then pray. Oh God, connect me to honor that is beyond my expectation. Oh God, connect me to honor that is beyond my expectation. You that connected Joseph to honor that was beyond his expectation. My Father, my God, it's my turn to be connected to honor that is beyond my expectation in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, connect me to honor that is beyond my expectation in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Now, last prayer point, prayer number seven, shout to the name of Jesus. Oh God, connect me to new and beautiful testimonies. Oh God, connect me to new testimonies and connect me to beautiful testimonies. Oh God, connect me to new and beautiful testimonies in the name of Jesus. Oh God, connect me to new and beautiful testimonies in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Almighty Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. And so, Father, we want to thank you for this moment of truth. I set our task in Jesus' name. Thank you, God, for choosing to connect us, the unconnected. I set our thanks in the mighty name of Jesus. We've raised 7 prayer points before you. Father, please answer us by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. And at the end of the day, let our testimony be that we have been connected. We that have been disconnected. Almighty Father, connect us, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus. And make our testimony to resound in the name of Jesus. Connect us with the unconnected to greatness in the mighty name of Jesus. And answer by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. And the next time we meet again, let us share great testimonies with one another in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Almighty Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen and amen. Praise the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.